I'm more than happy and more than honored to be playing for the Monger's 50th anniversary. You guys all know this, right? Great Lakes Myth Society, and they've had really cool shows before, and when they didn't ask me, I just had to demand to be on it, to be on the bill with them. But this time, we got asked, and that's really nice. It's nice work on our part.
We are gonna
start off one of the few covers that we know. And we wanted to play this song tonight because it is, it's called Extraordinary Times. It's by a local band from Detroit called High Strung. And it talks about just, you know, this good time we're having would be nowhere near as good if we didn't have each other on it. So this is for the Mongers. Uplifting song about togetherness and longevity to another song that's about really wanting to just give up.
Just kidding.
I wrote this next one. It's called The Darkest Things. I wrote it because I was trying to phasing out of songwriting a little bit for a while. And writing this song kind of helped me jump back into it. And so... Darkest Things. Here we go. Coming out, right? Coming out.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's beautiful. Of gone, I sing the same
Said this when we started, for all of you, there's probably plenty of you that came tonight solely to see our fiddle player, Carol. She is way under the weather, so she couldn't make it out tonight.
There should be three of us up here.
Yeah.
So hopefully you can hear a fiddle and, you know, three.
Yeah, just in case you're expecting to see Carol like crowd surfing on the stage.
So this is an old song. I had to pull some old songs out because I feel like you guys would, yeah, you know those, right?
We love them.
Because you're old. Is that what you said?
That's what I said!
No? This is off our first record. And I never get to play it because I don't know why we don't play it. I love it.
I do too.
Yeah, and it suits the season, so we'll just give it a shot.
Yeah.
Sure, getting me far. Sorry, and sorry, I still. This is my first time playing my songs here.
Misty, could you play two for us?
What do you want to hear?
Samuel in one note. Yeah. She told me.
Samuel's. Is it too hard?
You told me.
That's my favorite.
You were like. Oh,
if it's too hard, do you love it too? Okay.
Whatever.
But if it's gonna be hard for you, I don't want it.
I'll do it.
50 years of marriage is hard.
You're right.
Yeah, yes.
Oh, that
is
from the guy.
All
right.
Are we doing marble sleeves now?
Yeah.
Huh? No, Matt was hurt, so he's going to do marble sleeves.
I love it. We shouldn't even have...
We love it.
First thing, then. Just walk in and let them... We should have let you make the set list.
We could have.
Well, you are.
We just can never remember the names. We know all the songs.
Oh, my God, we have to sing them to me.
And Minneapolis is nice too.
Let's sing the solo thing.
What are we doing again? Marble sleeves.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Don't sing the solo thing.
Okay, this song is called Marble Sleeves. And
he's gonna make
better be good.
You're gonna be entertained. Don't forget, you're gonna be entertained.
Show me.
Yes.
Well, I'll be happy to watch you do
that. By the way, my mom is very happy that
you requested
that.
She's right. It's wonderful.
I'm always like, I'm retiring now. Once, too.
Aren't we?
You're dead to me.
You can play
on
them. You know this. Get your guitar out. It's happening.
It's happening.
Like, you're going to sit and watch.
I'll be wafting around in and out.
Welcome to our rehearsal.
Smile, Samuel.
play the drums most of the time.
Disclaimer.
I mean, with these songs that we used to play together as a duo, probably like 12 years ago or something. Maybe.
Not this one.
No.
Let me count.
What cable is that high?
Well, I don't know how to play the mandolin, so I just put her up here. It's like, don't look. A song from our second record, and I did write it. I remember writing this in a basement. I was living on 4th Street in Ann Arbor. It was like this hell basement. It's coming back to me now. It's like one week there's a flood, the next week there's flying ants.
Those cats.
The next week cats are peeing all over.
This cat had one tooth.
I can't remember his name, but
not many more hairs.
He hated me. And I was a server at the time, so I had an apron and I would put it on the kitchen counter. And one day, this cat hated me so much, this cat jumped on the counter and peed on my apron. Nothing else.
This was
like he knew. Oh, it's insane.
That's a song.
This song is, that's where I wrote
the kid's point. Name was like Striker.
He would look me in the eye while he puked. Do you know what I mean? I wish I was exaggerating this tree. Stricker.
It's okay.
This is actually, this is a hopeful song.
Yeah, it is a hopeful song.
It's about, you know, it's about being enough. What you got is enough.
Together. Never mind, we've been doing that all night. We have a special treat. Yeah.
There
hasn't been many. I have to say, the first time I have to recall, I always recall the first times I met people. I remember the Mongers. I remember being sort of infatuated with their son's band, Great Lakes, and just going to see that band all the time. And then Tim.
Church.
Yeah. And then Tim asked me to play a show with him at Taproom Annex in Ipsy. And I was pretty nervous to play with Tim. And I was like, wow.
Why?
Why? Because I was so, I loved your music so much by that point.
You're so intimidatingly musical. You're like so
well,
incredibly.
That's nice. It still hasn't gone completely in my head. I keep saying stuff like that.
I'll work on it.
But showed up and I was like, it's Taproom Annex. It's gonna be okay. And so I got there and Tim's whole fucking family's there. Like, Jamie's there, the parents are there, you know, significant others are there. It's just a party. And I'm just on this little stage and Taproom Annex is just like plinking and plunking my finger. And they afterwards were so sweet to me and just I felt immediately like part of the family and have ever since. I haven't written a song that they don't like, as far as I know.
You're right.
Yeah, please give it up for Bill and Mary one more time. This is another Civil War song. It's called Into the Valley, Tom Fool. Tom Fool being Thomas J. Stonewall Jackson.
Farewell, may God bless you all.
I was gonna play that new one that you like.
Oh, I love that one.
About
Friends,
yeah. Oh, but an omission.
Oh,
God, omission.
I love that song.
Oh, thank you, man.
Wait, is that what you want to hear? I have one last
one, though. Oh, don't make us choose.
That's hard. We might have to go to omission. I don't know. We don't want to argue.
You pick. No, after 50 years, we're no arguing. You pick whichever one of the two.
Whichever one you. We love them both.
Misty Lyn, run for 50 years.
Yeah. Oh, gee, it's gonna be big.
Okay, that's the one.
I don't see why not.
You know they can hear us. So we mumble like that to each other in the bar when everybody's yelling, you know, we're like, I'm here. Okay, well, let's do Old Mission then. This is a song about, obviously, Old Mission Peninsula, but I was trying to capture how it feels to be there. And I always gravitate toward death metaphors. So happy New Year.
Shows than my parents.
That's not true.
My dad used to go to my piano recitals and stand in the back, and I love my dad, he's amazing, and I will probably do this someday, but he used to wait till I got on stage and he'd gather up all my friends and go get ice cream. And then try to make it back before I was off stage. I kind of love it. I wish I could have gone with him. Okay, well, last night when we were practicing, maybe at the end of like a 3.5 hour practice, Misty's like, you know what? I think they really like Gillian Welch.
Oh.
Yeah, and you know, that would have been great to hear 2 weeks, maybe 2 weeks ago. And it was our original plan to play Great Lakes Men's Society song, and then we started delving into them and figured out that they're really hard.
We
went
on an acapella one, that's a nightmare.
Yeah, we went through two, well, I went through a bunch one day, and just like, nope. So when she said Gillian Welch, I was like, all right, we should do a song for them that, you know, but that's not by us. And we settled on one. And the thing about Gillian Welch and David Rawlings is that, you know, they're incredible harmonists and incredible songwriters. But David Rawlings is an incredible guitar player. I mean, just insane flat picking solos that there's no way you're going to be able to replicate. And so we can't play the solo. So we figured out a different way to do it. We didn't practice this, really.
Yeah. We can't wait.
Okay.
So, anyway, you guys probably know the song. I wanna, what is it called?
I wanna sing that rock and roll.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
And if you know the song, then you know the guitar solo, because it's famous.
It's like an iconic guitar solo.
So you get to sing it with us.
Oh, no.
We're singing the solo.
It's gonna be amazing.
Okay.
We crazy.
Upstairs, grab some more drinks, what do you need to do? We'll be up here shortly.
Thank you.